Hello there, my music lovers. I'm George from The File Heaven, and today we are having a late night look at the Hibi beans. This is a review I'm filming at night because I know how curious you've been about the beans from Hibi, so I'm trying my best to just get this video on time for you guys. The Hibi beans is a beanie interesting EM. This is priced at $70. It is in the entry level price range. They have one dynamic driver, which is an interesting choice for an entry level EM. Most Chinese producers nowadays try to go for balanced armatures and dynamic driver combinations or just all BA. Well, the Hibi company, the company of the dubs, decided to try with one dynamic driver, and they managed to get it to sound pretty coherent, and that is going to be a theme for today because the Hibi beans are coherent. They have a very basic case. I mean, I'm kinda bored of this case. It is cardboard, it is pretty flat looking, and inside you can find the Hibi beans and the carrying case. You must be very careful while unboxing the Hibi beans because otherwise you may not be able to rebox them. As a reviewer, I'm supposed to rebox those things because sometimes I need to take multiple shots for you guys, and this time around I actually managed to broke some pieces of the case. The case was utter hard to pull out without breaking that piece of cardboard, so please be careful with it. Here is the carrying case that Hibi chose to go with. This looks exactly like all the cases that FIO includes with their EM, so basically they all have the same OEM or OEM or the basic company that produces those, and then Hibi and FIO rebrand those things. You get a selection of 3 pair of tips, all silicone. For $70, it is a fair combination. I mean, you don't get a lot, but it's okay at this price point. On the other hand, some Chinese companies try to include some cheap foamies with their EMs at $70 and below $100. The first thing you'll notice about the Hibi beans is that they can be worn straight down. And I'm starting with that because besides everything, this is important. This is the first EM that can be worn straight down and which doesn't produce an enormous amount of noise. Those have almost no noise. They have almost no cable microphonics. I think the secret is that the cable is quite thick and quite heavy. It also has a somewhat sticky feeling to it. When you touch it, you kind of feel sticky on your fingers, but this works extremely well to reduce the microphonic noises. So I don't really hear it while brushing against my clothes, and I appreciate this. It is a pretty enjoyable thing. They also have a vent right next to the 2-pin connector, and this means that they have no driver flex either, despite being a dynamic driver. This is pretty cool. Being able to wear an EM straight down, first time in years of doing this review job. I've been reviewing things for you guys for a really long time, and I've been doing my best to review everything with a honest and pretty objective approach. And I always tell you when there is some microphonic noise. Most EMs that could be worn straight down have enormous amounts of microphonic noise. And we're talking here about fish, 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 fish. You just hear that cable rubbing against the clothes. With the Hibi beans, that is not the case anymore. You hear nothing. They are just silent. You can wear them, you can do some jogging if you are into those things, but all in all, it is a pretty good thing that they managed to reduce that. The EM shells are made of metal, and they actually feel a bit cold when first inserting them. There is a grill inside the EM that protects it from debris, and the tips are also pretty generic. They don't have a very special size or special types, so you should be able to use any aftermarket tips like SpinFit tips if you choose to go for them. The Hibi beans present quite a bit of hissing though. They are quite easy to drive out of my poco 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 phone. They are actually well driven. They sound very loud. Everything is just good. Also the dynamics, the detail, everything. So Hibi actually planned those ahead to be compatible with most smartphones, with most portables. They don't really need a lot of power to be driven well. Cool stuff from Hibi. On the other hand, I do hear a lot of hissing. They are pretty sensitive to hiss, and out of my smartphone, which is not exactly a hiss monster, it is not that silent, but it is not a hiss monster. Those hiss quite a bit. So if you are very sensitive to that going on in the background, well, maybe go with a more silent source. Actually, this video may have a lot of hissing too, because I'm in the process of upgrading my microphone too. Let's hope that goes well. And you may be hearing quite a bit of hiss from me too in this video, and I apologize for that. I really care about you having the best video possible, and I'm trying my best. So let's hope that by the time I do the next video, that hiss is gone. One thing I was not expecting about the HibiBeans is the cable connector. It is 2-pin and it is not MMCX. It looks very much like an MMCX connector, and I almost broke those thinking this is an MMCX connector, and I actually tried to twist it. I almost broke the review sample while just listening to them because I got curious. You know the proverb, the curiosity killed the cat. So be curious, but in moderate amounts. On the other hand, the sound of the HibiBeans is a nice punch. They are pretty punchy. Most of their bass energy is placed in the mid bass. They are on the overall level, they are pretty V-shaped. So the bass, especially the mid bass, is slightly enhanced above the mids, which are pushed back, and then the treble has a peak towards the lower treble, after which it rolls off. The detail levels are excellent for the $70 they ask for the HibiBeans. They are very much in the same lines with Dunu Falcon C, and I say this happy, because I know you can get that type of quality for less money, and I'm happy for you, my guys. On the other hand, I would say that the presentation of the bass is probably the most odd thing about this whole signature and tuning. The bass doesn't have a lot of sub bass. This is one of those first EMs where there is not a lot of sub bass, but there is quite a bit of mid bass. After that mid bass makes its entrance, you go to a more deep lower mid range, a pretty deep main mid range body, and then towards the upper mid range and the lower treble, there is a peak that gives sound a bit of energy and a bit of uplifting. After that, the sound just rolls off, so there is not a lot of information going on in the upper registers, so you don't hear a lot of air, but the soundstage is quite wide, quite open, quite spatial. You hear all those 3D sounds. And one thing I have noticed is that they work extremely well with acoustic music, with metal, with rock, even with pop. They are just not so great with EDM and with electronic music, because that lack of lower and of sub bass actually doesn't really complement and flatter that type of music that much. If I didn't know what I was reading on the EM shells, I would actually think that they are spelled Beats. This is how close to Beats the overall logo and the font they used. They just say HibiBeans, but they could actually get away by saying HibiBeats maybe. And I actually thought at first that they named those HibiBeats while seeing them out of their package. All in all, this is an EM with a fair value. We're talking about $70. We're talking about a sound that is pretty musical. It is somewhat generic in terms of being V-shaped. A lot of entry-level EMs are V-shaped, and we're talking about the entry-level range. The main competitors are something like the Shosi Hibiki, which runs for about $50, and the HibiBeans are considerably more detailed, more clear, more open, and they have better resolution than Shosi Hibiki. Another very fair competitor is Fio F9 and Fio F9 Pro, and those are much colder. The HibiBeans are considerably warmer, with more mid bass, with more body to the music. This actually works extremely well with rock and metal music. It doesn't work quite that well with EDM, and as I said, if you are a heavy EDM listener, there are many other options for you. So don't force yourself to listen to the HibiBeans unless you listen to rock. Bands like Dance Gavin Dance sound incredibly good, and before I knew it, I was thinking to myself that I'm listening to a much more expensive EM, and I thought to myself, wow, Hibi did it. They really created a nice EM, and they did. The HibiBeans are a very, very good choice at the $70 price point they are being sold at. Speaking of good choices, you know what would be an extremely good choice? To subscribe to Audiophile Heaven, also to leave a like on this video, as it keeps my motivation going up and I can create better content for you guys. I hope you are enjoying those videos. I hope I can help you by answering the questions in the comments if you have any questions. I hope you'll have a lovely week in there, and we'll see each other really soon. Bye bye.